Off in the distance, lightning strikes, leaving a beautiful flash of light, and then it's gone. If you blinked or looked away, you would have missed it and never known it happened. That is until the thunder rolls in. We all know that sound is slower than light, and that's what creates the phenomenon of thunder lagging behind lightning. And if you want to figure out exactly how far away a lightning strike is, there's a simple trick to use. All you gotta do is count the seconds between the flash and the bang, and for every 5 seconds that you count, adds a mile to the distance. Actually, it'd be 4.7 seconds if the air is already 70 degrees Fahrenheit and there's no humidity and also— Which means that sound travels at about 760 miles per hour. But what does that look like? By simply putting a camera on a car and then speeding up the footage in post, I can show you exactly what that looks like. If you were a sound wave traveling through the air, this would be your view. The speed of sound is really fast. However, it's actually not that much faster than flying in a commercial airline, so going the speed of sound wouldn't really reduce your flight times all that much. The Concorde, for instance, used to fly from New York to London at twice the speed of sound, and yet it still took 3.5 hours to complete that journey. Wait, hold up though. What we're seeing is the speed of sound through air. But what about the speed of sound through other things? As it turns out, the speed of sound is actually very different depending on what the medium is that the sound is traveling through. The primary thing that does determine the speed of sound through a medium is the stiffness of the material. The more rigid the object, the faster sound will travel through it. Well, technically, density plays a factor too. The more dense the object, the slower the sound. That is technically correct, but it doesn't play nearly as large of a role in determining the speed as the rigidity of the medium. Let's take water for example. Yeah, it's all sloshy and wet, but it's still way more rigid than air. And that's because you can't swim through the air. Duh. The speed of sound through water is over 3,300 miles per hour. In fact, it's 1.5 times faster than the SR-71 Blackbird, a spy plane famous for being able to hit Mach 3. That is fast, man. The thing about water is that it is incompressible, meaning that you can't squeeze it into a smaller space the same way you can with air. And that's partly what helps sound waves travel so much faster through water than through air. So it makes sense that sound gets progressively faster as you move from air to liquid to solid, right? So let's compare that to steel. Steel is obviously way more stiff than water because it's a solid, and a pretty hard solid at that. The speed of sound through steel is over 13,000 miles per hour, which is 17 times faster than through air. And what's cool about that is if you're on some train tracks and an explosion goes off a mile away, you'll hear it twice. First you'll see the explosion, but then you'll hear it through the steel only a quarter second afterwards. That's really fast, because through air it would take 5 seconds. 4.7. Now imagine that these tracks are made out of rubber and you wanted to hear that same explosion a mile away. Well, you'll be sitting here waiting about 26 seconds because rubber is one of the slowest mediums through which sound can travel. It is 5 times slower through rubber than it is through air. The speed of sound through rubber is 135 miles per hour, and that is so slow, I might even be able to reach it in my car. Here we go. Is I can't really see what's ahead of me. It's a perpetual mirage.
90. All right, 100. 6. We got the shot.
We just went 135 miles an hour. We just went Mach 1 through rubber. But let's imagine one of the fastest mediums, diamond, which is one of the hardest materials in existence thanks to its incredibly rigid carbon structure. And that allows for it to transmit sounds absurdly fast. We're talking 26,000 miles per hour, which is 33 times faster than through air. But also, more importantly, that is faster than Earth's escape velocity. That means that if you were going that fast, you would leave the Earth's gravity well and not come back, because that's as fast as rockets go when they visit other planets. Yeah, that's what escape velocity is. Now, get out of my video. Now, before I end this video, I really wanted to compare each of these materials against each other to really show you just the vast range of speeds different materials can cause the speed of sound to be. At the bottom of the pack, we have rubber here. Obviously, rubber is faster than you would normally drive in a car, but it's still gonna be super slow compared to any of the others in this category, so let's just move on. This is air. This is something we're a little bit more used to. So every 5 seconds of footage you see here, I'm going a mile down the road. So what you are actually seeing right now is the speed of sound. For these shots, what I did was I drove exactly 55 miles per hour. I had my cruise control on and I went that fast for about 8 miles. And then I was able to speed that up to really demonstrate exactly how fast the speed of sound is. Water is where we start really ramping things up. It's over 4 times faster than through air. So this clip will be 4 times shorter. Steel though, this is where we get fast, and it's done. And finally, diamond, which is so absurdly fast that it goes through 8 miles like this. And just like that, it was over. 1.1 seconds. That's how long it takes the speed of sound to go 8 miles through diamond. 1.1 seconds compared to 3.5 minutes through rubber. That is just mind-boggling. And we've made it to the end of the video. Thank you so much for sticking with me here. I had a really good time exploring the different speeds that sound can go. If you thought this was interesting, I'd really appreciate it if you shared it with your friends. Maybe hit that like button. Smash it, as they say. Here's a sneak peek for the next video. You know those little videos that show the different sizes of stars throughout the galaxy? Well, I think there's a better way to do it. Stay tuned and subscribe to find out.